Next in our program is the launch of UNESCO's new TVET strategy. So this is a very special moment within this conference. And I would like to ask David Atchoarena to come forward and present the new TVET strategy to all of us.
Thank you. I'm going to present in a brief format the main features of this new strategy. I mean, we've made already a number of times references to this new strategy that we are happy to launch here in Bonn at UNEVOC. I think that you were distributed the document, so you may have had a chance already to have a quick look at it. But I'll try to give you in a nutshell an understanding of this strategy. I mean, first of all, I'd like to stress the fact that we are positioning this strategic framework within the broader context of the 17 SDGs. And again, this tree represents the different dimensions of sustainable development. And for us, it's critical to conceptualize the role of TVET not only in relation to SDG 4, the goal on education and lifelong learning, but really as a contribution to the achievement of the other areas of sustainable development. And in particular, we are looking at certain areas of sustainable development which are represented, in this figure, for which we think TVET plays a critical role. In particular, issues of sustainable development, water management, decent work, quality education. I mean, those are the different, perspective for which we believe TVET can play really a transformative role, including, of course, climate action. Again, we are here hosted at UNFCC, and we think that there is a lot of scope and convergence for our work and our contribution through TVET to climate change mitigation. Now, if we look at more specifically at SDG 4, which is, of course, a particular, the key objective for UNESCO, and SDG 4 or Education 2030, as described in the Incheon Declaration, there are in particular three dimensions for which we think TVET is essential: access to quality provision, labor market outcomes, and equity and gender. I mean, those are the three specific targets which are actually listed under SDG 4, which relates and refer specifically to technical and vocational education. Again, as I was mentioning earlier this morning, we are, I think, in a very different era. You were familiar with EFA, the Education for All framework, and the Dakar framework for action with the six Dakar goals. And in fact, we didn't have a goal with a reference to TVET. There was a reference to life skills, but there was no specific mention to TVET. And as a result, during the years 20,000, I mean, since the entire decade, in fact, we had really a lack of policy attention to TVET, both at the national level, but also at the international level when we look at development aid. For UNESCO, now with this strategy, we're going to look in particular at three critical areas, which are employment, and in particular youth employment, which are also the contribution of TVET to equity and gender equality. And the third pillar, which relates to the transition to green economies. Again, the overall goals of the strategy are, first of all, to support member states in their efforts to reform TVET systems, and also, of course, a contribution to implementation of the new sustainable development agenda, including, of course, goal 4, but also, as I mentioned earlier on, contribution to some of the other goals for which we think TVET can play a strategic role. I'd like to mention that this focus on three pillars is something that was decided as a result of a consultation process. In fact, many of you did contribute to this process because we had a consultation with the UNEVOC network, and thanks again for your contributions. We also had consultations with member states and with our sister agency, notably the members of the international the Intergy group on TVET, and I'd like again to thank them for their contribution. So it's really, it has been really, I would say, a participatory exercise with the TVET community at the national level, with member states, and with our sister international organizations working in this area. So we think that with those three dimensions, we are really addressing some of the most critical issues, on the policy agenda, in terms of youth employment, in terms of equity, gender equality, and in terms of sustainability. So let's look at the first pillar, which is youth employment and entrepreneurship. I'd like, first of all, to recall that we have really a massive challenge to face in this area. I mentioned earlier the figure of 73 million young people being unemployed in the world. So it's really, in terms of the magnitude of the challenge, it's quite significant. We also, we also have about 1.4 billion young people who are in vulnerable jobs on the labor market. So this issue also is quite important. We're not only talking about unemployment, we're also talking about vulnerability on the labor market, which is a growing concern, not only in developing countries, but also in developed countries, including in Europe. So this is really a matter of policy attentions in most parts of the world. And this was very clearly, expressed by our member states, in particular at the last General Conference of UNESCO last year. So the first, area of focus for UNESCO in this field of supporting youth employment will be to actually provide the support in the field of policies. So both in terms of assisting countries in reviewing their policies. We've already started this line of work, but also in supporting TVET reforms. And here I'd like to refer to an important instrument that was adopted at the last General Conference, which is the revised recommendation for on technical and vocational education and training. As you know, UNESCO's role is also to produce normative frameworks, normative instruments in this field of competence. We have a number of normative instruments in the field of education. And we, as you know, we actually embarked into the revision of the normative instrument for TVET, the recommendation for TVET again. This is a process in which the UNEVOC network made a strong contribution, and the revised recommendation was adopted last year at the General Conference. It's also worth mentioning that this was done in combination with the revision of the recommendation on adult education and learning. So we have two instruments, I would say two instruments that were revised at the same time, which really provide a very useful framework for countries to actually design, implement, and monitor their policies towards establishing lifelong learning systems. So again, you know, what we are, you know, the way we engage with countries in the field of TVET and TVET reform is also related to the broader field of lifelong learning, including, of course, adult learning. A second area of focus for us in this work will be to really consolidate partnerships. We are already doing it in particular through the interagency group on TVET, which I mentioned and which met yesterday. The interagency group beyond and besides you know, sharing information, developing coordination of programs also focuses on particular policy areas. We have, for instance, a working group on indicators, another one working on work-based learning, which is a very important modality to promote youth employment and also entrepreneurship. So we will continue to engage and further develop our cooperation with other agencies, international organizations, but also bilateral agencies, including GIZ, for instance, when it comes to the cooperation with Germany. Funding it constitutes a major challenge and often is seen as a major obstacle to the expansion of TVET provision. Again, this is an area of you know, policy attention. There are a number of different, I would say, regimes which you know, are in place in different parts of the world to mobilize resources for TVET. We mentioned this morning with the example of Costa Rica, the use of payroll taxes as you know, a useful way of diversifying sources of funding. We are actually finalizing a review, an updated review of payroll taxes at the international level, which will provide very useful information on the potential, you know, that can be mobilized at the international level to actually secure funding in a sustained way and in a way also that mobilizes enterprises. The second area of focus has to do with equity and gender equality. We are in the world at the moment, you know, I would say, in an area of increasing inequalities. So when we look at the distribution of wealth, we see that indicators show that there is not, you know, the world is not moving towards more equity, but we are actually moving in the other direction. So this is really an issue. It has also to do with the situation of people and young people in particular on the labor market. The status of workers on the labor market and also the capacity of people to have access to TVET. So how to promote more equitable policies, more equitable TVET systems that can actually facilitate a fair access to the labor market and to lifelong learning pathways. This is a very important challenge. So we will be focusing, I mean, the second area of work for us will be in this area, with first of all, you know, first of all, an engagement in relation to in the field of policy, with a specific focus on equity and gender equality, but also with a focus on the capacity development programs, and this is where our UNEVOC International Center and the UNEVOC network, I mean, so yourself will be playing a critical role, because you are really, you know, UNESCO's arm to develop capacity development programs. And I'd like to mention in this framework the new flagship program on TVET leaders, which is being launched by UNEVOC, that will also, you know, contribute to make, I would say, TVET institutions better informed and better equipped also to contribute to more equity in access to TVET and in the delivery of the TVET program. Second area where UNEVOC also will play a critical role is knowledge sharing and dissemination, which is also quite important in terms of policy learning, how countries are approaching this issue of equity in provision, including in the area of gender equality. Disadvantaged groups are also, I mean, beyond the gender issue, continue to be a very important challenge in most countries. And in particular, I'd like to refer to two categories. First of all, the issue of informality and, you know, the large share of the workforce and the youth engaged in work in the informal economy, and this is not a new topic, but it's a topic that actually calls for renewed attention in terms of how to improve not only the working conditions and promote decent work, but also ensure that those people, those young people in particular, do have access to continuing training and to lifelong learning opportunities through TVET. Another category of workers and of learners that deserve particular attention when it comes to TVET policies are the rural people. Again, we've had some illustration of this with a presentation from Nigeria. So this is, you know, an area where specific, I mean, targeted measures are needed to actually reach out, you know, this size of, I mean, this part of the population, which continues to, in many countries, represent a very important share of the poor people. We will also, of course, as I indicated, look at the specific measures for gender equality in TVET. We had, in the case of Morocco, an interesting, I think, illustration of a country where, in terms of participation, the country has almost reached parity in terms of access. 42%, I think, of the enrollments are female students in the TVET system in Morocco. But yet, there is an issue in terms of their concentration in particular trade areas, which are not necessarily the ones conducive to employment and lifelong employment. So there is an issue also in terms of the distribution of women across the trade areas covered by the training system. So this also is continues to be an area of focus in terms of guidance, information, in terms of incentives, but also in terms of the way employers are engaged and participate in those policies to ensure that beyond training, women do also have access to, I would say, equal opportunities in terms of employment. The third area has to do with the so-called green economy, transition to the green economies, response to climate change. I mean, climate change is both a threat, but it's also an opportunity. You know, according to the projections, there will be up to 60 million jobs, new jobs, you know, created as a result of the development of new new sectors, new jobs, to actually address this or respond to this challenge. So this has implications for the training system in terms of preparing industries to actually change some occupations, but also create new ones. So it's, you know, really a challenge, but also an opportunity for transforming the TVET system and actually guide and promote access for young people to new occupations which are conducive to this transition. So this will be an important area for the work of UNESCO in the years to come with countries. We've had a very, I would say, interesting debate on this matter already in Paris in December during COP21, where there was also a particular segment to which we contributed related to the TVET and the contribution of TVET to green economies, green jobs, and you know, responding to climate change, and we anticipate that this work is now, you know, ongoing, and we anticipate that it will, you know, further accumulate with new initiatives in Morocco for COP22. So again, promotion and preparation of young people and promotion of new skills for green economies. This will be the first dimension of this pillar. We will also, in that context, promote cross-sectoral approaches of TVET. We've had an interesting example with a presentation from Serbia of how different policy domains need to actually, you know, be brought together to develop effective cross-sectoral TVET policies. And this is certainly something which is much needed in the context of the new SDGs, where we have to also look at other policy areas in terms of food security, in terms of health, in terms of cities and urban policies. So really, you know, how to bring those different policy areas together to design effective intervention. This is something that will, I think, capture a lot of our energy and thoughts, both at global level with our colleagues from the other agencies, but also, of course, for you at national level. So this, you know, constitutes really a challenge that we will need really to take up in order to move forward in an effective manner in the new sustainable development agenda. The technical, ICT was mentioned by several participants, delegates this morning during the first panel session, both as a new skill that must be mastered by, in fact, all learners, including TVET learners, but also as an instrument to promote and diversify modes of delivery, in particular to reach out fragile target groups and women in certain areas. So this is also a field in which UNESCO will invest, I would say, increasingly. We already have some initiatives which have been taken by the UNEVOC Center in this field. We are about to have a publication in this area, but certainly this is a domain that will drive, you know, really further attention in the years to come, and we need to be able to guide in an effective manner countries in this field. We have, in addition to those three pillars, we have three transversal also areas of work that I will mention very quickly, not to cut too much on your lunch time, just to mention that we will launch, in fact we have already started within the framework in particular of the Interagency Group on TVET to initiate work in relation to skills anticipation, how to, you know, actually what methodologies, how to involve stakeholders in this process, how to use skill anticipation approaches to better guide the policies and training delivery. So this is an important topic. We will also We will also continue to work in the field of qualifications and how to better define qualifications, how to build qualification frameworks, how to articulate national qualification frameworks with regional qualification frameworks. We see the emergence of regional frameworks in many parts of the world. And finally, we will work in the field of data and indicators to be able to adequately monitor the the strategy, but also the SDG targets related to TVET. And this will be done in close collaboration with our institutes in Montreal, the UNESCO Institute of Statistics. I would like to end my presentation here just to say that we have actually shaped the afternoon session around those three pillars, because the implementation of the strategy will rely on you. We count on the full engagement of the UNEVOC network to actually, and on the partners to actually engage in implementing these three pillars. So we have actually organized the three working parallel sessions, each of them dedicated to one of the three pillars. And I believe that you have already registered to continue the discussion within that, that framework. So I thank you for your attention, and I look forward to the outcomes of your discussions during those working sessions. Thank you.
Thank you very much, David, for the presentation of the new UNESCO TVET strategy. This is what will occupy us from 2016 to 2021. And as we had indicated, also it's our responsibility to take this forward jointly, and the afternoon sessions will be dedicated to that. Let me also tell you that you have received a copy of the strategy in your bag, but French and Spanish copies are available outside. And for those who joined us through the webcast, you can also download the new strategy from the webpage. At this time, we would also thank those joining through the webcast for their participation. It will end now. So thank you very much for your interest and for joining us.